So yeah, I've heard a lot of times hunters say, and myself included, that when you're out on a deer hunt and you see a coyote, it immediately turns into a coyote hunt. And like I said, I've done that personally. I've turned several deer hunts into coyote hunts, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. But the question is, does the research support that, for instance, another saying that I've oftentimes heard that for every coyote that you kill, that's one more fawn. And the truth is that it doesn't necessarily. Based on what we've seen in the research, you have to remove a significant portion of a predator population on an area before we start to even see marginal and much less substantial improvements in what we're often looking for, which is fawn survival, which leads to recruitment, which leads to population growth. So how much of the population are we talking about? Sometimes it's it takes removal of up to 80%. Say if we're talking about coyotes, 80% of the coyote population in a given area before we start to see improvements in fawn recruitment rates. And that's most easily accomplished oftentimes through trapping, very intensive trapping efforts, probably focused primarily on the time period of year when fawns are dropping on the property that you're managing. And the reason that that trapping effort needs to focus on that time period of the year is because we've seen through recent research also that coyotes very quickly fill back in on properties where territories are vacated. And in the past, a lot of times, both as biologists and as deer hunters, we think that the mechanism by which coyote populations recover following, let's say, intensive shooting, intensive hunting, or intensive trapping is by compensatory reproduction. You shoot a bunch of them, their reproductive rates go up, and the population recovers the next year. But what we're finding through GPS tracking of coyotes is that it doesn't take a whole year for that population to respond following population reduction by trapping or hunting, but rather it can happen in a matter of weeks. And the way that that occurs is through immigration of new individuals who previously did not have territories coming into that area. So basically, we don't even have to go through an entire reproductive cycle for coyotes to repopulate an area because we have numbers of individuals in the surrounding areas that are looking for territories to occupy. And when those territories become vacant, they quickly fill back in, leading to a rebound in the coyote population almost immediately following the reduction in that population.